In our chat room, Marla asked the question. She says a friend of hers, when she was growing up, her friend lived in her family's funeral home. And she said she remembers she was 30 years old when she first visited. And she had to go pick up the phone while she was there and realized that the phone was a Sports Illustrated type casket phone. And so she wondered, do you ever have those moments in your own life where you can poke at the lighter side of what is such a deep and serious topic?
You know, Sister Marla's onto something there because, you know, my father's habit was to bring my two widowed grandmothers home from church on Sunday and get them liquored up a little bit and set them arguing about religion or sex or politics, whatever wasn't covered in the homiletics at church. And they'd argue about a lot of things because they were sort of opposite in their sensibilities. One was a rabid Democrat and an Irish Catholic. The other was a quiet little Methodist woman who converted because she fell in love with an Irish Catholic man. She would always say, "Be careful, boys, because the ridiculous and the sublime belly up to the same bar." And if you unpack that, she's absolutely right. I mean, that you know, the good laugh and the good cry share the same space. So things that happen in the funeral home for no, you know, I mean, a really good funeral, as far as I'm concerned, makes room for both the sort of the belly laugh and the acute grief that we associate with a death in the family, you know. And so, yeah, there are, you know, there are still guys walking around with putters that look like coffins, you know, because they get a kick out of it, you know, or they have tie clasps that look like shovels to indicate to everybody they know that they're an undertaker, you know. So it's there's a black humor attached to our work.